Hi, and welcome to our overview of the new Explorer component within NetSupport DNA. As you can see, we're on the main welcome screen for the DNA console, and alongside the home icon is a new Explorer icon. When we select the Explorer icon, as you can see, we're presented with a set of real-time thumbnails from a number of connected devices. These are PCs that are currently available within the sub-hierarchy of example here. If I drill down to curriculum, you can see I will just see the thumbnails of those machines and so on. The thumbnail frequency can be selected from the thumbnail menu at the top here. So these can be updated every 5, 10, 30 seconds and so on. And in addition, we can also adjust the size of the thumbnails to suit our viewing requirements. As well as indicating the name of each PC, if we've chosen alongside our PC name to show an owner or last login details, that information will also be presented under each of the active thumbnails. In the case of this thumbnail here, you'll see that there are a digit 1 and 2 shown against them. This denotes a dual head system, and so we can see the first monitor and then the second monitor by clicking accordingly. Or we can select that individual PC on the hierarchy, and in doing so, we can then see both monitors in real time on the screen at the same time. That gives us a quick overview of the thumbnails being displayed for each of the PCs within our system. As you can see on the view, we have crystal clear thumbnails from each PC. Of course, there may be times where for a given department, we need a slightly higher level of privacy, perhaps for staff within the school or within the finance department. So having selected a department, perhaps the curriculum team, we can go to our settings mode, and under our settings options for our Explorer view, you'll see we can either disable thumbnails or we can apply privacy mode. So let's choose privacy mode for this department and apply that change. And as you can see now, all of the PCs within that department have their thumbnails in privacy mode, and the two outside of that department remain being clear. As well as our thumbnail view, we can also view machines across the enterprise in icon mode. And again, the colors represent the departments within the hierarchy. We have an indicator for the operating system, and alongside that, we have the PC device name. Once again, we can choose to show the last logon details or additional information if we require. The third and final view is our details mode. And if we select details mode, you'll see for any selection of PCs, we have the details of the computer name, the department those computers are in, their IP address, their last connection to the DNA database, the last logged on user ID, the operating system information, and then we have a set of three notifications. The first is where there has been a keyword triggered against our safeguarding component. The second is where one of our system alerts has been triggered. Perhaps a machine's running low on disk space, CPU utilization is too high, or something similar. And the final one is linked to our USB endpoint security, where someone has requested that a memory stick can be approved for use. As soon as a machine meets any of those three criteria, as you can see, a highlight is displayed to indicate that attention is required. We can choose to enable or disable that option. Alongside that, we have our active policies view. So here we can see which machines have a power management for power on policy that's been set, one for power off. These machines also have an inactivity policy, an internet policy for restrictions and web monitoring. In this case, there are no application restrictions active, but there are endpoint security restrictions in place. We also have on these machines webcams disabled to enhance our e-safety policy. The thumbnails have not been disabled, but they are in privacy mode, as you can see here, as opposed to the top two machines in a different department that clearly don't have these settings. And the benefit of this feature is that when we look at the school as a whole or an organization as a whole, we can quickly see which machines do and don't have policies set. So typically we might expect all machines to have their power management enabled other than servers. We may expect all student machines to have endpoint restrictions in place, but not staff machines, and so on. Now, once we've identified machines that, in the case of this example here, need some kind of attention, by right-clicking on the PC, we're presented with a range of options. We can change ownership details, we could distribute some software to them, we could check the real-time status of that PC, we could launch a remote control session, either remote controlling their screen, transferring files, or launching and creating a remote command prompt. We could send a message to that user, chat with that user, Depending on their status, we could power the PC on or off, particularly handy out of hours if we need to power on a group of machines outside of our normal power management schedule, so we can perform updates, and of course we can apply updated information to those machines ourselves. All in all, the Explorer view is designed to give us that almost real-time view of activity on the network, identify where machines need assistance and attention, and all the time give us the reassurance and comfort of what activity is being undertaken across the network at any given time.